Well, in this case, we're going to dive in to what happens if Wonderland Time fails. So with that being said, my name is Dan from the Hidden Gem Network. Welcome to this video. I'm not going to make it too long. I'm going to get right to the point. First thing is first, thank you so much for everybody who joined the Immortal Monks Monastery DAO that they're launching Discord through my link. You guys have helped me. Now, I haven't won just yet, but remember how I said, whoever sends the most invites, they're doing a contest, will win this NFT giveaway airdropped. What I'm doing, I already talked to the admins and whatnot. I'm allowed to. I'm going to be giving it away to one random person who's watching this. And if you go and follow me on Instagram, I'm going to post it on my story in the upcoming days. If I win, there's still a few hours left. I could be beaten by a bunch of bots. No, I'm just kidding. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to win. It looks relatively in my favor. But if I do win, I'm going to be giving it away completely randomly to one of you. I'll put it on my Instagram story on how you can actually participate. And one other thing, they actually released their inside look, a sneak peek. And one of the monks actually said, this APY is just a filler number, just so everybody knows. But this is how it'll look. You can stake the Immortal Monk over here. It looks really clean. So again, not why you're here. Let's actually get into why you're here. What happens if Wonderland Time fails? So I want to give a quick shout out to Price Time for this video. What happens if Time Wonderland goes wrong? This is actually the inspiration for this video. But the reason I'm actually creating this video is because this is 12 minutes and 14 seconds that can be condensed into, quite frankly, about a minute. So with that being said, it's a great video if you want to learn more about inflation and how, basically currency is backed by X, Y, and Z, depending on the country. He talks about Venezuela, talks about US. Really intricate video. I'll link it down below as well. So I'm always in for supporting other creators. It's a good informative video, but I'm going to give you the TLDR on how Wonderland can actually fail. So now let me give you the worst case scenario here. So stakers pull and sell, because they want to take profits or, whatever it is. And that increases the actual supply. So the supply of time raises because they're selling their time back. They're just selling their time. So there's more in circulation. And here's the thing is because they're unstaking, that means people are leaving. There's a falling demand for time. And this results in a downward price trend, right? So the price will obviously go down, which essentially, like I said, lowers the price of time overall. And if the price of time overall, the entire market value of time at that current moment, if it's, low, relatively low, that means the DAO Wonderland makes less income when they actually sell the time, right? So when they actually go ahead and sell the time to people that mint, they're making way less income for the actual protocol itself. Inevitably, that's going to lower the total APY. So if the APY goes really low, it starts to drop significantly, it's going to scare away a lot of stakers and people that are participating in the Wonderland Time staking pool, essentially. And what happens there is that it's just a massive cycle. However, there's one factor, there's one key number we need to look at. Backing per time is one of the most important numbers that we need to go ahead and keep in the back of our mind. So what is the backing per time? So the worst case scenario is the DAO, in this case Wonderland, the Treasury Reserve guarantees the backing of time. So it can't go down below currently $2,073 because the Treasury right now has enough liquid in their balance to be able to buy back all of the current circulating time supply and burn those tokens. So long story short is if the market price hits backing value, so if we have time reach 2073, then Wonderland will buy back tokens at market value and burn them. And if they burn the tokens, essentially the price starts to go back up. And then a new wave, a new cycle happens of new investors that come in and invest into time. So again, it is very, very, very heavily predicated on new investors. So that truly is the worst case scenario when it comes down to time. Now, it's important to understand that this is why having first mover advantage is so important. And that's why we see something like Jade Protocol, right? Yesterday, I made a video. It was at what? Like 90 or maybe $70, $80 million market cap. Again, there's not a lot of active participants in Jade Protocol as of yet. Let's face it, right? Jade isn't you know, relatively old. It's a newer protocol. So that means there's still a lot of people coming to the platform. So if we take a look at something like Jade Protocol, and just so you know, I'm going to base this off of the index. So if we just go to stake index time, what this means is if you staked from the very beginning, this is the multiple that you would have on your time. So if you staked one time in the very beginning, you'd have a multiple of 5.18. And we can see right over here, staking returns since start 2.19x since it actually went ahead and opened up to people being allowed to stake. So if we quickly just take a look at Jade, we can see when this actual contract was created. And at TX, here we go. It was created 18 days and 18 hours ago. So like I said, Jade is relatively new and they're still airdropping over $1 million per week in airdrops. And again, just follow them on Twitter, keep an eye on them. But what I'm telling you is that this is brand new. And that's why I'm so heavy on pushing Immortal Monks, is because it's not launched yet, but you can get into it first. And if you're first, right, and the actual DAO gains a lot of traction, you're going to just make an absolute killing. And I'm telling you, the hype that's around Immortal Monks, they have, oh my gosh, they have 9,000 members now. I think I opened this up in the beginning of the video with like 8,900 or something. But again, long story short is that you can be there the moment it opens. Like, that's what I'm trying to tell you, is these opportunities are incredible because you don't need to wait for the cycles that I mentioned before, like with Wonderland, is that you get in at the ground floor. You are the person that's going to reap all of these rewards. You don't have to wait for that new wave of new investors to come in and, you know, essentially kind of raise the price of time again, or whatever protocol you're using. So again, first mover advantage, always have an eye out, always have a lookout for these new DAOs that you can go ahead and stake in. These protocols are printing money right now. This is where the space is, where people are just focusing a lot of their attention. Just get in on the ground floor. So just as a quick example of getting in on the ground floor, I've been getting so many tweets for a while now about Metaverse Pro. So it's a BSC OHM fork, so Olympus DAO fork on the Binance Smart Chain. So if we go ahead and just see, if we just take a look at their contract, we could see with the TXID, the Meta token, it was created 24 days and 13 hours ago. Now, here's the thing with Metaverse Pro. Their angle that they're taking is the reverse currency for the Metaverse GameFi. Again, not their angle, but you know what they're trying to accomplish with this particular, with essentially this particular reserve currency for literally Metaverse and GameFi. I just regurgitated what it literally says. So let's actually take a look at their stats, but let me just reiterate the fact of being early. Like, again, I can't emphasize this enough, is being early with a lot of hype around these protocols is what you need to be doing. So, you know, following, not even me, like I hate saying follow me for I'll tell you stuff. The only reason I know stuff is because of you guys. Literally, it's because I get people like you, my followers. I hate using the word followers. Just other people like me who just want to learn about the crypto space. You guys tweet me, I take a look. You guys leave comments, I take a look. I just get informed, get plugged because of you guys, and then I regurgitate it back to you guys if there's enough people that go ahead and talk about it. And this is one of the key things that I learned about being a content creator in the crypto space, is that I had millions of views on various different TikTok accounts that I created just for fun, probably like a month or two back. And I ended up garnering like 20 or 30 million views in about a month collectively. And I noticed something, is all the comments, people would shill like crazy. They would go ahead and be like, oh, this. And I would start picking up on the most shilled, like what everybody kept commenting the most frequent. And I would notice a pattern of stuff just going up. So like, one of the reasons I'm telling you this is because I'll actually tell you stuff that people just keep talking about and talking about and talking about, and just that amount of engagement alone will warrant me to look into it and actually tell you and show you about it. I don't ever suggest investing in anything speculative like this. As a matter of fact, you should look at me as like a rock talking. If a rock tells you to put your money into something, or you think of listening to a literal rock to invest your money, that is your fault if you lose it, okay? I'm just like you. I'm in this particular space to try and maximize my gains and just make sure my family eats and we're good for life. So Metaverse Pro, I have not staked it. I have not tried it, nothing. But you could see, back to my point, we could see right over here, 1122. Yes, there was obviously a dip over here. I think it was due to the entire market, to be honest. But first movers, again, like first movers before the hype was there, is that, you know, the initial token was released and out of nowhere, not out of nowhere, but as the hype was starting to be driven up, bam, almost double. I'm pretty sure it's double, actually. Yeah, it's double at its peak, right? Even if you held all the way from the very beginning, you bought at $230. Right now it's at $300. Even with individuals taking profit and just bouncing around to other protocols. So what I'm trying to emphasize here is that you gotta be aware and just first in on these protocols. And I hope I didn't do this to Jade, because I saw this yesterday, right? I talked about Jade yesterday, and I've just been talking about Jade a little bit, but I noticed my Jade views and engagement when I mentioned Jade keep going up. So I personally hope that I didn't have a direct cause in this over the last day. I would feel horrible, and that's why I don't talk about, you know, these little coins and whatnot, but I thoroughly love these protocols. So when I talk about these, be careful, especially when they're super low market caps or they're super speculative, because just like Jade, I'm not saying I was the catalyst for this, but if it starts to, you know, really catch a lot of traction on my videos and people start really just talking about it and it goes pretty, you know, viral, if you will. I wouldn't even say viral, but it just starts garnering a lot of attention. You don't want to be buying the tops. Like, don't buy the tops. Just wait, okay? So all of that being said here today, I just want to say that you got to keep your eye on the streets, fellas and ladies out here, all three of you that watch my channel. So again, just keep your eyes peeled. The best place to do it, subscribe, notifications, my Twitter. You can use, you can just run a Twitter search. Like, look at this, ready? Just do this, OHM fork, ready? OHM fork, let's just see what the top ones are. What are people talking about? What is this? Midas Dow, 1,108 followers on Avalanche. Brand new. Could it be a rug? Can it be a scam? Possibly. Chances are high. But just go through, literally, you can find these gems yourself. Just literally run a Twitter search, searching OHM fork. You'll find so many different, with like 950 followers. This is crazy. Look at this. I already found two of them with barely any notoriety, barely any clout. This is literally how you can go in and dig deep. However, if you decide to go all in, that's your fault for listening to, of course, a rock. Not the rock, but a rock, because I am a rock. I am learning with you guys. I am earning with you guys. And I hope on this journey, we can do it together. My name is Dan from the Hidden Gem Network. Smash subscribe. Like this video, I guess. I don't know what else to say. That's it. Goodbye.